Hello, welcome to my channel on the subject Engineering Graphics. In this video, we'll see about the solution for the Anna University December 2018 afternoon question paper. Okay, the subject code is GE8152 Engineering Graphics. Let us see the first question. The first question is 1A, draw the freehand sketches of the front, top and right side view of the pictorial view shown in the figure. All dimensions are in mm. So this is the object given to us. You have to solve the, you have to give the answer for this particular problem. Okay, so I'll be showing the answer straight away, not in step by step. Okay, if you have any doubt, pause the video and then once you clarify your doubt by yourself, you can go for playing the video and continuing the video by playing it. So this is the object in 3D, solid rendered image actually. So this is the isometric or the pictorial view of the same. Okay, this is the three different orthographic views of the same. This is the front view, top view and right side view. Generally, as per the first angle projection, the right side view will come to the left of the front view. So make a note, you have to draw these three different orthographic views, front view, top view and side view, by freehand and give the dimensions and differentiate the visible and hidden edges. Hidden edges must be drawn by thick dashed line type. Okay, shall we see the next problem? Yes, the next problem 1B. A circle of 50 mm diameter rolls clockwise on a horizontal line for half a revolution and then on a line inclined at 60 degrees to the horizontal for another half a revolution in the same direction. Draw the curve traced by the point P on the circumference of the circle, taking the topmost point on the rolling circle as the initial position of the generating point. Okay, so this particular, the answer for this particular question has got two components. For half revolution, it rolls on a flat surface, horizontal surface. For the next half revolution, it rolls on an inclined surface, inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. So this is the answer for this particular problem. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please pause the video. Okay, then see the image carefully, you will be good to know and you will understand the answer for this particular problem, for this particular question. Okay, so this is a circle here. We are tracing the point P, here is the 1', okay, we are going to trace the locus of the point 1' on the circle while in motion or in rotation. So initially, this is the flat surface. The AB, capital AB, is the length which is equal to half of the circumference of the circle. That is pi r. 2 pi r, 2 pi r is the formula for the circumference of the perimeter for the full circle. For half circle, for half revolution, it is not 2 pi r, it is pi r, pi 25, since the diameter of the circle is 50, right? So for the first half, so initially the at time t equal to 0, the center point is at O. After 1/12 of the rotation, it has been moved from O to O1 and so on. Okay, so after 1/12 of the rotation, point 1' moved to 1/1. The next is next it will move to 2/1, next 3/1, 4/1 and 5/1. Finally it touches B. The 1' touches B, okay, at the end of the half revolution. After that, it will travel on an inclined path, inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. So for this, you have to extend this line AB and you have to draw a 60 degree line such that it is tangent to the circle. Now immediately the contact is established at point C. Now the distance CD must be equal to the next half revolution, that is half of the circumference of the circle, pi 25. Okay, so after this, while it rolls on this 60 degree inclined surface, the path traversed by the point 1 dash, or as per the question, it is point P suppose. Okay, it will travel on this particular trajectory. Okay, so here AB is the length of the first half revolution of the circle. Then the circle start rolling on 60 degrees inclined surface. CD is the length for the next half revolution of the circle. Okay, so again I repeat, if you have any doubt, pause the video, see the image, see the notations and the drawing and its placements carefully, so you will understand the problem thoroughly. We move on to the next problem. 2A, second unit. The front view of the line AB of a length 70 mm is inclined at 30 degrees to XY line and measures 45 mm. That is, true length is 70, front view length is 45, its angle alpha equal to 30. 1 and A is 20 above HP, 25 in front of VB. Draw the projection and find the true inclination with HP and VB. I solve this particular problem using a parametric modeling software called SolidWorks. So here you will be seeing only the answer, the notations will be missing. Of course I included the dimensions, except the notations, the answer is you can get to know the answer from my video. Right, so this is the answer, this is the question. 1 and 20 about 25 in front, alpha 30 degree, its length, front view length is 45. Okay, this is the front view, top view, preliminary front view. From the preliminary front view, already the true length is given in the question, 70 mm. So this you can get the true inclination theta. The exact value of theta as per my SolidWorks drawing file, it is 18.75. I make it 19 degree. As I said in my earlier video, generally even if I draw the answer for this problem in the drawing sheet, I may make some mistakes and errors. So the plus or minus 2 or 3 degrees will be generally allowed. Okay, theta here exact value is 18.75, but 19 degree is okay, or 19 plus or minus 2 is okay. Similarly, pi 49.99 degree, so 50 degrees. Okay, if you develop a CAD a solution in parametric modeling software under drawing, you can solve any type of straight line problem within 10 seconds. Yes, it is not a joke. In reality, you can get a solution for any straight line problem within 10 seconds in any of the parametric modeling software. Okay, I am using one and only SolidWorks. You can use any of the softwares like CATIA, PROE, Unigraphics, etc. Next problem, 2B, position of planes. A regular pentagonal lamina of 30 mm base edges rest on one of its corners on HP. Draw its projection when the surface of the plate makes 60 degrees to HP and top view of the diagonal passing through that corner on HP makes 45 degrees with HP. So first read this statement. Draw the projection when the surface of the plate makes 60 degrees to HP means you have to assume initially that it is 0 degrees to HP, that means parallel or in HP. When a plane is parallel or in HP, then naturally the initially you have to draw the, you have to start with the top view. So draw the initial top view, that I call it first front top view, corresponding first front view, because this problem has got three sets of front view top views. Okay, so first you start the top view, in that you draw the pentagon such that left extreme end is a point. Okay, then only if you tilt it, the corner A will be on the resting on the HP or on the ground, right? So initial top view, corresponding front view. Now go for the first tilt. Tilt this first front view, this is the second front view, in that it makes an angle of 60 degrees with HP. So this is the second front view, this is the corresponding top view. Okay, here I considered AC or A1C1. AC or A1C1 as the diagonal. Okay, so as per the problem statement, the top view of the diagonal passing through that corner is the resting corner is A. So the diagonal passing through the resting corner A, there are two possibilities. One is one diagonal AC or A1C1, the other one is AD. Okay, I chose AC. So initially, now it as per the drawing, it is inclined at some angle. Okay, but you have to tilt such that A1C1 angle is inclined at 45 degrees with VP or 45 degrees with XY line. Right, so I made it. So this is the third and final top view. Draw projectors on the horizontal lines, get the third and final front view. This is the answer. Okay, so now the second unit is over. The third question, 3A. A pentagonal prism 30mm side of base and axis 70mm long is resting on one of its edges of the base in such a way that the base makes an angle 40 degrees with respect to HP. Draw the projection if the axis is parallel to VP. Okay, so axis is parallel to VP, that means axis is inclined to HP. Okay, so you have to start the problem from the front view top. I go back, makes an angle 40 degrees with HP. Okay, so you have to draw the you have to start from the top view. In top view, you have to draw the pentagon. Okay, so this is the pentagon, side is 30, so the right extreme is an edge. So then if you tilt, the edge, base edge CD will be resting on the ground. Okay, so this is the corresponding front view. Tilt this front view such that the base is inclined at, the base makes an angle 40 degrees. So the base is inclined at 40 degrees. So this is the final, second and final front view. Draw projectors, horizontal lines, complete the final top view. Okay, to get this view, the observer has to see this from this end. For this observer, this is the farthest point. It is not a point actually, it is a line. So two edges, the lines connecting thus two points, totally 3 plus 3, but one is common, so totally 5 edges are hidden or 5 edges are not visible. So this is the answer. Okay, if you have doubt, pause the video and see it carefully, understand the solution for this particular question. We'll move on to the next question, 3b. Again, it's a solids problem. A cylinder of base diameter 30mm and axis 70mm long has its cylindrical end that is inclined at 30 degrees to VP. It is not 30 degrees to HP, it is 30 degrees to VP. So you have to start the front view maybe. Draw the projection. Okay, so in front view, draw the circle. Okay, complete the corresponding top view. Now you have to tilt this top view such that the base is inclined at 30 degrees. It here in the question, the cylindrical end is nothing but, there are cylinder has got two ends, top face and the base. I say this as a base. This base or the end is inclined at 30 degrees XY or VP. Again, as usual, draw projectors, horizontal lines, complete the picture. Okay, here cylinder has got infinite number of generators. You darken and show only the boundary generators. Darken only this boundary generator and that boundary generator. Don't darken the in between lines or the generators. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, now we move on to the next problem. The third unit is over. The fourth question from the fourth unit. Okay, 4A. A hexagonal pyramid base 30mm side and axis 65mm long is resting on its base on HP with the two edges parallel to VP. It is cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP, which is inclined at 45 degrees to HP and intersecting the axis at a point 25mm above the base. Draw front view, sectional top view and sectional side view also. Okay, and true shape of the section of course. For all the sections of solids problem, you have to show the find and show the true shape of the section. Here they asked one more thing, that is called the sectional side view. Okay, so this is the hexagonal pyramid in top view, hexagonal pyramid in front view. I showed the right side view. For getting the right side view, on the left side you have to draw a vertical x1 y1 reference line with respect to this x1 y1 reference line, and this and combining this top view and front view, complete the right side view, okay, or the side view, right? That's why I mentioned here. Here I have shown the sectional right side view. Okay, so it cuts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slant edges out of 6. This slant edge O dash D dash is completely removed, and it cuts the base. So 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 base. Since it cuts the base, plus 2. There are 7 cutting points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, keep track on all the 7 cutting points in top view, side view, and also for the true shaped section. I hope you know the procedure for getting and completing the sectional view, sectional top view or front view, true shaped section, and side view, as well as a sectional side view, right? So if you have any doubt, pause the video, see the answer, okay, till you clarify your doubt by yourself. Okay, we move on to the next problem, 4b. It's a development problem. 4b, a cone of base diameter 60 and height 70 is resting on its base on the ground. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to the VP, parallel to HP, at a distance 20 mm from the vertex. It is also cut by a plane inclined at 42 base, meeting the axis at 20 above base. So there are two cutting points. One, the first cutting point makes the cone as a frustum. The next cutting point is inclined. Okay, very simple standard problem only. Okay, so this is the top view, this is the front view. This is the first cut. Okay, cutting is parallel to HP. Okay, it becomes frustum. This is the second cutting plane. It is inclined at 40 degrees to HP, meeting the axis at 20 from the base. Okay, so keep track on all these cutting points. For this, you need not calculate the cutting points. Okay, now first you develop the full solid. For that, this is the formula. You have to take the true slant length. The generators O dash A dash and O dash E dash shows the true slant length. So either you take O dash A dash as OA, capital OA, or O dash E dash as capital A, with this as radius, O as center, draw arc first. Okay, you have to find out the angle for this sector. Okay, the formula is theta equal to base radius by true slant length into 360 is equal to OE, that is nothing but the radius. Okay, base radius divided by O dash E dash or O dash A dash into 360. So 30 something something. So final answer will be 142. So this sector angle must be equal to this 142 degree. Since I divided the circle into 8, divide this arc also into 8, show all the 8 generators. Okay, so for this first term, O dash, the distance with this distance you take, set it in the compass with capital O as center, draw this arc. So that is over. For this, transfer all these cutting points onto TSL. The generator shows the true slant length. Take the measurement from here, mark it on the corresponding generator. Right? So this is the procedure. Okay? So after that, you join all the points in proper sequence. Thereby, you will be completing the problem. Okay? We move on to the next problem. Fifth unit, 5A, isometric projection. Draw the isometric view of a hexagonal pyramid of base side 30 mm and height 70 mm rest on its base on HP with the base edge parallel to VP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 45 degrees to HP and meeting the axis at 40 mm to the base. Of course, it has got two components. One is the projection of solid, and there introduce the section of solids, mark the cutting points, section points, Okay, go for there is a method for getting the solution in isometric. Okay, follow this way. So this is the top view and the front view. I introduce a cutting point. It cuts all the six slant edges. There are six cutting points. Okay, to start with, to draw the hexagon, base hexagon in isometric, you have to follow the box method. Okay, so for that, you have to draw the box first. Put the box in the orthographic. Draw the box in isometric by drawing 30-30 degree lines. Okay, so after drawing the box, get the distance distances of A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, from orthographic, mark those distance or the lengths in isometric. Thereby you will be completing the base in isometric. Okay, I'll tell you the how to mark the cutting point 1 in isometric. You have to follow the same procedure even for the other 5 points. Okay, so now this height is marked in red line, red color, right? And here also I made it red. So okay, first you draw this red color line, okay, in this box PQRS, right? So first of all, take this measurement, maybe that draw the mark the point here. Okay, parallel to this line, using a minute after scale, you draw this red line in isometric. On it, it is meeting this the 1-1, the cutting point 1 is on in front view, it is on 1-a-. Okay, so 1-a-, that means the top view of the point 1- is 1, the 1 will be here. Okay, so it is, of course, it is at the midpoint of this line, so mark it here. So 1-1 is the projection of the cutting point 1 on the base. After that, you draw a vertical line in isometric. For to mark 1, take the height of 1- from xy, this height, okay, using divider compass. Okay, by taking this height with reference to 1-1, mark the point 1, thereby you obtain that point. Actually follow the similar procedure for the remaining 5 cutting points. After completing it, draw line joining 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, by in proper sequence, thereby you will be completing the section in isometric. Then darken and show only the visible slant edges. So thereby we will be completing the solution for the truncated pyramid in isometric. Okay, next problem, the final problem, 5b, perspective projection. A rectangular pyramid of side of base 30 mm into 20 mm and height 40 mm rest with its base on the ground, such that one of the longer base edges is parallel to picture plane and 15 mm behind it. Longer edge, the 30 is parallel to PP and 15 mm behind PP. The observer is 50 mm in front of picture plane, 25 mm to the left of the axis of the pyramid and 50 mm above the ground. So the central plane is 25 mm to the left of the axis. Axis is seen as a point in top view, of course, right? So draw the perspective projection. So this is a question. First you draw a picture plane. With respect to the picture plane, complete the top view. So the longer edge AB, whose length is 30 mm, is parallel to and 15 mm behind picture plane. So 15 mm behind and it is parallel to it. With respect to this, complete the top view. Okay, and complete the corresponding front view. The gap between PP and GP will be slightly more than the sum of above and in front of distance of the station point. Okay, the observer is station point means observer and the station point both the same, 50 mm in front and 50 mm above ground. So 50 plus 50 100, maybe plus 10 more. So the gap could be 110 mm, maybe the apt gap between the PP and GP. So below PP line, maybe at a distance of 110 or more, slightly more, mark the GP line with respect to that, complete the front view. The next is central plane. The central plane is 25 mm to the left of the axis. So, axis is seen as a point here in top view. This is the axis here, right? From here, it is to the left. So, CP line. On it, mark the station, top view station point S, which is 50 in front. Front view station point S dash 50 above ground plane. Okay. After that, the procedure is very standard. Okay, you know it already. Connect all the top view points with the top view station point S. Connect all the front view points with S dash through intercept. For example, to mark capital A, capital maybe O. Okay, this is the intercept that you obtained while joining O with station point S in top view. So we, from here, from this intercept, through this intercept, draw a projector. When it cuts the line joining S dash O dash, this is capital O in perspective. Follow the similar procedure for the remaining four points, the base points A, B, C, D. Okay. Now here, the point C, the edges connecting point C are hidden. Darken only the visible edges. Show the three hidden edges B, C, C, D, C, O by thick dashed line tag. Okay. So this is the answer for the fifth and the final question. Okay. So I hope you got the answer for all the 10 problems of Anna University December 2018 afternoon question paper. Okay. Good luck.